primary design goal of the Spark project. At the time, mobile relay was basically the only choice. There were a couple other inline editors available at the time, but none of them with none of them even close to production running like mobile. But the funny thing about mobile is that it's still not really ready for production, even today. Like, it's still rapidly changing, deciding what it wants to be. And then November 2012, CKEditor released a new major 4.0 version, which was kind of like a big surprise to everybody. Ta-da, guess what? You know, CKEditor also does inline editing now. So basically combining the inline functionality of mobile, but also has all the maturity and stability of the CKEditor project for going back the last 10 years. So it was kind of a David and Goliath sort of situation. And we launched a which editor was going to be the right one for us. We evaluated it on 27 different criteria, including all kinds of different crazy things: accessibility, performance, stability, developmental features, filtering system, translation, accessibility, license, tools, file size, history, testing, all kinds of things. The entire comparison is up there on the screen. Thank you for doing that. But ultimately, ready today, and Aloha had a long road to go before it could really be ready for armor use. That's actually not to say that CKEditor was perfect for armor uses either, and WYSIWYG in particular, who's up here in the front row, has done a tremendous amount of work working with the CKEditor team to improve the functionality of CKEditor so that it matches the expectations of what we need for going forward. So let's talk about the actual WYSIWYG integration itself. When I first proposed WYSIWYG in Drupal 8 back in Drupal Online, and I imagined the architecture to look like this, that there was one WYSIWYG editor in core, and there was the filter system that it was going to integrate with. And my rationale was that if you have a WYSIWYG in core, there's no need for something like WYSIWYG API, because once a WYSIWYG is in core, everyone is just going to use that WYSIWYG library. Like, the other libraries don't really matter, because the one that is in core will become the de facto standard because it is in core. Nobody will go searching for another WYSIWYG if the out-of-box WYSIWYG experience is good enough. Actually, as it turned out, that's not, you know, Drupal people in my instructions. That wasn't really acceptable to most. So we actually end up with this situation where, editor module is basically a binding layer in between the filtering system and the CKEditor module. And the editor module is the generic, essentially equivalent of WYSIWYG API, but with some deeper integrations in some places and less integrations in the other situations. And here's what happens out of the box. In Drupal 8, when you install it, it adds a WYSIWYG on for everything, basically, out of the box. It is there, it is turned on. But if you were in the situation where you had used the minimal install profile or you turned off the editor module, what you get is you have this text format page that we have today, essentially, in Drupal 7. WYSIWYG experience itself. So the actual WYSIWYG experience, it's CKEditor. It looks like CKEditor. It's largely very centered around dialogues. Like, dialogues will form the basis of all of our advanced editing functionality, like all of our file handling, things like that. But the nice thing about our dialogues is that we're not using like CKEditor's normal just dump it. It's not going to make it. So far, we don't really know what's not going to make it. We haven't gotten as far as we need to be. But like I said, we do have a unique opportunity where we'll be able to push the features that are much closer to release than a lot of other features out there because we're so single version. We don't have any like deep developers underneath us. So far, instead, make it so that all decided on one, like this is our editor, doesn't mean that we have removed any of the flexibility of replacing this with a different editor recommended. Like, basically, the idea is that we're going to make an editor where WYSIWYG integration is so great, nobody's going to ever bother replacing it because the level of integration is so deep. But that doesn't mean that the integration isn't extensible and it isn't swappable. It definitely will be both of those things.
So, an upgrade path, I
said that this functionality of like the actual tags being in it isn't quite convenient, but it's pretty close. Which makes it so this offering really gets a bit. There's also some patches to consolidate all of this under filtering stuff because pretty much most people don't understand these ideas. They understand I wanted a button for this. They don't understand something like the filter processing. Thank you. yeah, that'd be great. Next question. Two questions. First of all, I'm wondering, you mentioned WYSIWYG, that's currently what we use and what our users are used to using. And I'm wondering if there's been any conversation going on with them to get the integration to the same level that you have with CKEditor. It's interesting. We had discussions with a lot of big players in the WYSIWYG market when a big CMS like Drupal is considering such a big move. Actually, I got a lot of unexpected filtering that makes it representative of what the PHP filtering is going to produce on the front end. Perfect.